So in this video, I want to go over 5 habits that will completely change up the way not only that you play 2K, but also how you approach the game from a mental standpoint. If you're trying to get better, then definitely stay tuned. You already know, luck got you. The first habit on this list that will completely change the way in which you play NBA 2K has got to be to slow down and stop abusing the turbo button. I can't explain to you how much better you will become by implementing this change to your game, both on offense as well as on defense. First, offensively, with the ball in your hand on offense, you should be using the turbo button more so as a change of pace to try and catch your man's off guard, tapping it here and there when needed, or in order to activate a dribble move. In my opinion, the only time you really want to mash down on the turbo button is on the fast break if you have numbers, or if you beat your man and you got the open lane in front of you, and other select times here and there. But again, for the most part, you should not be holding down the turbo button for entire possessions at time. One of the main reasons why you shouldn't be holding down on turbo when you're dribbling is because you end up making it way too easy for your defender to guard you. All he has to do is attach himself to your hip and pause, ride you either way. Rather, you should be forcing him to have to react to your movements and then play off of his reactions. Also, when turboing with the ball, one will most of the time end up not giving a play enough time to develop, and you will often end up outrunning the play, so to speak, or forcing a bad pass because you unturboed your way all the way to the edge of the boundaries. And then it's pick your poison, you know? Continue going out of bounds for the turnover or throw an errant pass for the turnover. But most of the time in this situation, it ends up in the turnover. And then off ball, same thing goes. You don't need to smash down on turbo every time that you want to relocate around the court. One, you end up with little to no stamina once you do get to where you're going, and hitting the shot just became that much more difficult. And two, you end up screwing up the spacing by turbo cutting into the action and bringing your defender to help double the ball. Most of the time, it's actually better to just walk it out or a nice brisk light jog around the court. Ideally, even just cooling out in a spot and letting the offense happen around you and come to you. And then on defense, it's easy. You only turbo when your matchup turbos. Otherwise, you should be playing regular, squared up defense. Turboing on defense will oftentimes lead to you overrunning the play or getting your ankles snatched. That Jamal Murray behind the back and John Wall monster step back are a defensive turbo abuser's worst nightmare. The next habit on this list that I wanted to hit on is going to be for us folks who like to take pride in our defense. And that's going to be to stop hugging your mans on defense. Especially if your mans has been backdooring you all game. Pause, that was wild. But you do not need to be hugging your mans in order to play effective off-ball perimeter defense. Hell, most people don't even be wanting to take the shot anyway and are usually suspect from deep. So you pushing up on them and hugging them is essentially playing right into their hands, because all they want to do is finish anyway. Rather, what you should be wanting to do or looking to do is to take a step or two back and force them suckers to hit that shot. Make them earn your respect before you start hugging them. Something crazy out there. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying to sag off all the way into the paint, but you can take a step back and just hold up on the right stick with your hand up. The next habit that we should all look to be picking up that will immensely improve upon our game and change the way we play 2K is going to be to 1, master our roles, and then 2, staying within the confinements of said role. So in the building process, we should be deciding what type of player we want to be on the court. A lead guard, a shooter, or perhaps a lockdown or a big. Whatever role we decide to make our builds at is what we need to be trying to master first before going off and trying to pick up other skills. So all you big men out there, learn how to box out and gain some type of post game if you're an interior big. And if you're a stretch, master your jump shot and its timing. Get that shit together way before you start trying to dribble the ball up court. And same thing for us guards. If we made a lead guard, then that's what we need to be doing, leading the show, making sure everybody eats. Get down to basics of dribbling and reading the court, and then you can work on becoming the next Diesel with the dribble. And PGs, stop running away from the inbound, God's sake. If you wanted to be a shooting guard or a small forward, you should have made them. Trust me when I say, by mastering and playing within the dimensions of your build will make you such a better player, because now you're using what it is that your build is good at, and ideally have good stats in, to your advantage. The next habit that will take your game to the next level is going to be to make better use of icon passing. I'm sure we are all using the icons, or at least I hope we are, but we need to be using it more often. In my opinion, it should be the main form of passing. We already know how no matter how you set up your passing profile and settings, when you need to make a timely pass to the open man, simply hitting the pass button will oftentimes lead to the ball going to the absolute wrong person and usually ends up in a steal. Instead, we should be trying to pull up them icons and ensure that the ball is going to the person that we want it to go to. But the key here is not to leave your icons up the entire time. Otherwise, if you do end up popping open real quick because your mans was sagging off, or you blow by your mans and end up at the rim, you'll end up fumbling with that RB button and messing up your scoring opportunity. Rather, similar to how we should be using the turbo, you're gonna wanna feather the passing button. And I know I've said this in other videos, but from my experience playing rec, I find that when I'm bringing the ball up court, I like to leave my icons up, at least until I cross half court. I mean, I'm not in a position to score anyway, and the only thing that I can do effectively is pass. So it's okay to leave the icons up during this time. And also when I'm on the perimeter and I just got the pass, I'll pull up the icons real quick before I start to make any moves, just so I can see where everyone is lined up. So in the event that I do beat my mans and help comes, all I have to do is identify the direction that the help is coming from. The next habit on this list that you should add in order to help to elevate your 2K game to new heights is going to be to turn on that good old live stream and record your games. Just like real athletes and professionals watch back their game films, we should be doing the same and reviewing our own games. That's because the benefits and insights gained from studying film and breaking down your own gameplay is pure gold and worth the time invested. One key benefit being that you will be able to spot your own weaknesses and see where it is that your game starts to deteriorate. Perhaps your shot selection is hot garbage, or you're over dribbling and missing wide open shot attempts or passes. Well, film study is where you will see these things under a microscope. And because you're looking at it from an outside perspective, i.e. you're not actually playing the game, you will see your flaws magnified greatly. A next benefit of film study is you get to understand your opponent's game. Listen, while no two games of 2K will be the same, everyone uses the same handful of animations. So while you're doing your film study, see how people are using these animations to their advantage. Are they comboing them up, or even how much space they need in order to hit a shot? Me personally, I've picked up a lot of combos just from watching how other people manipulate their defenders when they're on offense. Also, like I said, everyone uses the same animations, so defensively, you should be taking note of what combos with what, and also the best way to defend it, obviously. Like for me, from watching so much film, I've learned that on the fast break, especially on defense, start breaking down around the three-point line, as that's around where everyone likes to hit you with that Jamal Murray behind the back into a usually wide open three. But that's just a bit of what I picked up from doing way too much film study. And just real quick, I know the idea of having to sit and watch through a whole 30-minute game sounds both daunting and tedious, but you can definitely cut it down, just focusing on key moments like critical possessions or the last few minutes of each quarter or half. And I ain't even gonna hype you. It really wasn't until I started doing this YouTube thing that I started obviously recording my games to watch back. And trust me when I say, it's been invaluable to making me a better player on court. So give it a try, you know? And a quick bonus way to elevate your game, and probably the fastest way, in my opinion, and shout out goes to the homie Jersey Made on this, because it was his ex or Twitter post that reminded me about this feature, but it's to go out and run you some blacktop. To quote Jersey, it's the 2K hyperbaric time chamber. If you're struggling at any specific aspect of your game, or you're working on learning a new move or jump shot, the best place to go and work on the finer details and pick it up fast as hell is in the blacktop on Hall of Fame. All you gotta do when choosing your player is hit Y a few times if you're on Xbox, and then you can pick your My Player, and from there, it's time to get to work. Just a quick note, remember, we're here to get better and improve on our skills, not cheese the AI. But these are just 5 habits that if you added to your game or the way you approach 2K will honestly make you a way better player. But till we meet up on that virtual hardwood, luck out. Peace.